Hello, I'm Mr. Peoples. This is 4.1 Flex, and we are doing a YouTube makeup tutorials. Again! We never stop. Hey. Never stop, never stopping. All right, so today we're going to do facial hair using some crepe wool. Yes. And it looks disgusting, and it feels even worse. But it's going to be fun. So the secret to getting crepe wool nice and straight, usually it comes in a big braid and it's crimped and it's crazy, and so you have to straighten it out. And my wonderful assistant, Kaylin Curry, back there, has used the steamer you see over the back of her head there, that little steamer going, to steam out this hair so that's nice and straight. And now what we're going to do is we're going to apply this to our model, Caden's face.
Yes.
Awesome. All right. So all we really need, we're not going to do a full makeup application today. All we really need is spirit gum and a brush, some crepe wool, obviously, and then isopropyl alcohol to remove it when we're done. Okay. So I'm going to start by pulling these pieces apart. All right, I need small, manageable wefts of hair. Wefts, W-E-F-T-S. Please be quiet back there, whoever's talking or shuffling about, whatever you're doing. It's very distracting. This is gonna go up on the YouTube channel, so you know you wanna conduct yourself much more professionally than me so that you come across well. I don't care what people think, so I'm gonna be crazy. You know what I do need, though? Oh, an ultimate mistake that I've made already. Teachers making mistakes? Never! What I do need is a pair of scissors. Sophia, will you hand me a pair of scissors from over there? Some nice little snips. This will work. These are a little bit bigger than I would usually use, because I don't want to cut off any noses or ears. But this is okay. So what I want to do is trim all the crazy wispy hairs away. And I usually try to do this at an angle. Ooh, these are really dull. Can I get another pair of scissors? The small snips would be best, yeah. Thank you. Okay. These are a little bit better, although they get a little residue, but they cut much more easily. So I have a nice little angle here. It's about a 45 degree angle across the width of the weft of hair that I'm using. I've actually got a lot of hair here. I can thin it out a little bit and take about half of it away. It's okay, we're learning, we're learning. Someone shut the door, the music is very loud. Okay, so I've got that. I'm gonna have a time opening up this bottle here. It has been glued shut.
Can we put it under the steamer?
Would you see if you can find the newer bottle of spirit gum up there? It should be with the toilet paper roll and the spirit gum, or the glue and stuff. Do you see it? It's a huge bottle.
Yes.
There, that's it. Thank you. Brand new. This one should open just fine.
Yes.
That's how you cheat the system, my friends. Okay, so now we're going to dip a little brush into the spirit gum. You don't need a super huge amount. First of all, what do you think we should do? Mustache?
I don't know. I'm fine with whatever.
Okay, well, we'll do a mustache, but I want to warn you, it's going to smell really strongly. It's not going to hurt you, but it just has a really strong smell. So I'm going to start with just the corner. And I'm going to hang this over the edge of the counter because I don't want to get it on the counter. All right. So notice I've started with just a little space here, a little patch of spirit gum in the corner of his mouth there. That is to keep it from curing up as we go towards the center. So if I were to, you know, say, oh, I want to do a mustache, so I'm going to paint the whole mustache area with spirit gum. Well, by the time we get all the way to the end of our project, the spirit gum won't be sticky anymore. It'll have already set. So then we'll be messed up. Yo. Kent, will you mind turning off the steamer for me before it runs out of water? You never want your steamer to run out of water, because it will ruin it. Okay. So, one more time, trimming these hairs again. 45-degree angle. Always try to pull away the like wispy hairs. Okay, so I want to check here, and I'm going to use my finger to check to see how sticky that is. And it's pretty sticky now. We call this the tacky phase of post-spirit gum. That doesn't mean that Caden is, you know, poorly dressed. It just means that it's ready to apply the facial hair. So when I do this, I want to think about the direction that the hair grows on the face. So a good rule of thumb is to pretend like his face is the face of a clock. And if the center of the clock is right here, we know that the hands are going to radiate out from the center. So pretty much anywhere you go on the face, that line from the center out will tell you the direction of hair growth. So I am going to lay this so that the hair is going in a straight line from the center of the face outward. Do you see that? And then will you turn your head a little bit so everyone can see? Cool.
Wow.
All right. What's that? Oh, I thought someone had a question. You can ask questions, please. So, and right now I'm using my scissors to tap down into the spirit gum all these hairs, these loose hairs. And now that I feel like I've got a good connection, I'm going to pull away the excess hairs. Okay. And then I'm like, well, I don't want him to have like such a long, crazy, fuzzy mustache. He's not fuzzy, was he? He's... Okay, so I'm going to use that hair that I pulled away, and I'm going to trim it just like I trimmed the previous section of hair, 45-degree angle. Okay, I'm going to turn it, and I'm going to layer it on top of the hair that I just did, pressing it into the spirit gum as well, just to see if there's any extra spirit gum that I didn't connect with. And there was some. Okay. Now I'm going to add some more spirit gum to his face. I'm doing this in little sections. So he's gradually going to become Burt Reynolds over the course of this. Into this, he'll be starring in Cannonball Run. So now we gotta let that get kind of tacky there. Can anyone guess, and I know some of you guys have been in my class, so you know the answer, or hopefully you do. Can anyone guess why we work from the outside in? Anyone know?
Mm-hmm.
Anyone brave to take a guess? Come on. Okay, Caitlin.
You work from the outward in because you're layering.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Because if we started from the center, that hair would, you see the direction of the hair growth? So this hair in the center has to lay over top of all this hair. So the further in, the more it has to lay over. So we start with the most outside set of hairs so that all of this can overlap as we work inward, okay? Otherwise, we'd be like mashing it on top of the other hair, and then it would look really weird and be messy, really messy. So when I'm getting hair, I'm trying to find a weft. Often I'll just go in, pull this apart piece by piece. And this crepe pull is all different lengths, so it's really easy to pull apart. It's not like one long braid of hair like you would have cut from your head, like if you were donating to Locks of Love or something, you know what I mean? Where you have to like get your hair cut into from a ponytail or whatever. This would be like all different lengths, so that pulls apart pretty easily. And you don't want to ever cut into a weft or a thing of crepe wool, because it has all those different lengths, and then you'll get all different size pieces. So you always want to pull it apart until you're ready to stick it right on the face. Awesome. Sorry, I'm gonna run into your nose there.
It's good.
It's worth it to have this awesome mustache. You go home today and show your family, and they're gonna be like, "I respect you now, son." Here are the keys to my car. Hello. Yeah, you don't have to ask. We're in the middle of a YouTube tutorial, so please don't disturb us. Finding another weft can be challenging when you have so much hair hanging out. Okay. Pull that apart. I probably need to go back in and add some more spirit gum because I'm running out of space here. So I'm going to come in a little closer to the center here. And then we're going to go over to the other side and work our way in. Going in sections, it's kind of slow going, but if you rush it, you're going to make it look really bad. So we try to take our time. It's kind of a good color here that we're using. It works with your color. It's not exact, but it's not terrible. So you also want to put the spirit gum down in really thin layers. You don't want to put too much on there at one time because it will not dry quick enough. And then you'll be sitting here waiting forever for it to cure and to get to that tacky stage. So the thinner the layer, the quicker it gets tacky. So we're probably almost there. I think we can go ahead. Yeah, bless you. Something I've noticed during these flex periods is that kids that don't have me in class, that don't know me, will be sitting here listening intently. They look like they just hate me so much. I'm looking around and I'm talking to y'all, and you're like, "Don't you dare ask me a question." I'm like, "Whoa. Maybe they do hate me. I don't know." You know, no judgments. If you hate me, it's okay. Bye. Once again, interrupting our video. How selfish. How selfish. Don't they know this is my time to shine? Come on.
How do you teach? It's always your time.
And it's not enough, honestly.
And as we said anymore.
That's why I'm in Rocky Horror at APT. Come see it. Closing weekend this weekend.
Closing weekend. Go see it. Fantastic.
That's a selfless plug. Or a shameless plug.
That was anything but selfless.
Anything but selfless. Shameless, selfish plug.
It's so good.
It is.
Whispers. Your whispers. So good. Distracts from my own self-interest. And I like it. Come on, people.
You should know by now.
We just discussed this. I'm greedy. Sally Field, I'm like, they love me. I want you all to love me. They love me. They really love me. So I'm just layering. I'm almost done here. Ah! Oh no! It's terrible. The worst thing that could happen. Not really. It's fine. Okay. So, I'm going to go through and kind of pull out some of these crazy hairs before you inhale them, poor guy. trying to keep you from dying here. ODing on crepe wool. What a way to go. Well, I told him not to inhale it, man. You got a little whiff and that was it. Never looked back. Mm-hmm. All right. Oh yeah, if anyone knows a washing machine supplier. We're in desperate need of a washing machine here at the BHS Theater Department. Ours is gone now because it broke. And,
rest in peace.
We need a generous donation of a washing machine. That works. Let me suffix it with that. Yeah, I can say I have sponsors now. I'll do a little local ads for that company. Also put them in the program for our shows.
Yeah.
And that's real. Your ear with spirit gum somehow. Hold on. Man, you were looking so cool. Like you could be a sheriff in the Wild West right now. So good.
perfect time. Hey, Mr. Peoples, I need to borrow your keys.
I know. Rude. Just keep them, please. I don't want them back.
Key?
I accidentally left the light on in the TV.
Honestly, they do that every week. Like, please just keep them. Just keep them until you don't need them anymore. So yeah, once you get it down, it's pretty exciting. I'm going to have to apply a little more spirit gun. Looks like I'm losing my tackiness here.
I'll never lose your tackiness.
Yeah. I know, who thought I'd ever say that? Me, not tacky.
Possible.
Impossible. I'm the tankiest.
You're not wrong.
I won't cut your face, I promise. I've done this before once or twice. And never cut her face. Okay. Just keep them, please. Gosh. They don't work. They'll never learn.
I got it.
I really just wanted them to keep them because I know they're going to come back and need them again. And then I'm going to say, ha! I told you so! Just like that. In a very mature way, though.
Oh, yeah.
Very adult, mature way.
Of course.
Well, now I have a question. Does anyone want to give it a try? Anybody want to try to lay the last little bit of hair? There's not much left. No one's brave enough. Man, we have a bunch of cowards up here. You want to try it? Come on. Yeah.
Woo.
She's going to be brave. We're going to give her a round of applause. Come on.
Clap, 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 clap.
Okay. So, I have a weft here. It needs to be trimmed at a 45 degree angle and then placed on a face.
Okay.
Right here.
Okay.
Okay. Here's scissors. Kind of hard to cut with, just so you know. Okay? And
ooh,
you can have
a seat.
Yeah.
Wow.
Just watch yourself with that. Oops, excuse me. All right, let's do it over here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're just not easy to cut with.
Spoiler alert, I've taken his theater class before.
Yeah, she's
I've known
a
it
cheater.
For about 3 years.
What a cheater.
I know. Do you already have spirit gum on them? Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yeah, so you'll want to use the scissors to help press it down. How's she doing, folks? How's she doing?
Nobody's gotten cut yet.
No, perfect. That's a job well done. Looks like he's 45. Yeah, if you look.
Like a suburban dad. Or like
he's
a
really
barbecue.
Yeah. Got enough
like,
long day.
Well, I just got off work. Jewelry.
You cut these unevenly.
I'm home. Ready to
each side
dig into this meatloaf.
Dig into this meatloaf.
Do you want me to do the middle too?
Yes, please. This side is pretty much done. It's just this side that needs to be finished.
Okay.
So what really happened here was Mr. Peoples gave up.
Huh?
Nothing.
Saying I gave up. This
no,
is, or
never.
This is what I would look like.
No.
Both.
But yeah.
No offense.
It looks like that one dad that'd be like doing the sprinkler at like a.
That would honestly be me.
Have you seen the show Crazy Ex-Girlfriend?
No.
Oh, there's a character on there who's kind of nutty, but he has a mustache like this. Like, if you don't watch out, you could be him.
He would make you wear polos and boat shoes.
Polos and boat shoes.
Yeah.
No. Crocs and socks.
No. Stop.
Just stop.
Let's not bring that back.
You never know. They're really cute.
The yellow.
No, they're teal. What's the color of that backpack? That color? Teal. It's my favorite color.
Yellow Crocs?
Welcome to Croc Talk.
Welcome to Croc Talk. This is Flex 4.1. Discussing everyone's love and fear of Crocs.
I love Crocs so much.
They're okay, I guess.
My sister wore them all summer. And they were embarrassing because they're neon yellow.
No, I went to Dollar General and as I was walking out, I saw this old lady and she was wearing like bright yellow Crocs with like her like dark outfit. I was like, see? Okay. And she was driving in a pickup, so I was like, you go, girl.
Crocs are fun.
Crocs are
fun. I have a pair of Crocs. They look like boat shoes.
Oh, you can't smell it?
That's a good thing.
Because you've gotten the hair up in your nose.
Yeah.
How you doing? You almost done it, Caitlin?
I think so.
Just have a look in the mirror when you get to that stopping point.
But I mean, you cut it both each side a different length, so.
That's okay. Well, I'm not done, right?
Yeah, you can trim it up when you're done. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, don't question my. Don't question my methods.
I mean, I understand your methods.
It's
okay
to question. It's okay to question.
Mr. Peoples knows.
It's always good to be inquisitive. Have an inquisitive mind. Right?
Yeah.
Life is boring if you don't ask questions. You're just walking around in the dark.
And here's your helpful tidbit for the day.
Life lessons. If I was on TV right now, a shooting star would fly over my head. And the more you know would pop up. Get in that T-bird.
I have a crepe roll all over my hands, and I hate it.
Anybody got that ZZ Top album? All right, you wanna move out, and I'll take over.
I mean, you can do the last piece that needs to go on.
Oh, sure. I'll finish her up.
This one.
Ah, ha ha! Is there spirit gum there already?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm going to have to salvage some here. Alright, I think I can do it. Everyone, I need you to imagine that I'm Tinkerbell and applaud for me so that I can exist.
Yay!
Alright.
I believe.
Notice how everyone stopped because they want you not to exist.
No, everyone did it. Everyone did it, okay? At the end. Story complete.
I faked it. You're dead.
I've never encountered so much hatred in my life. It's a good thing. I mean, this is the worst.
Welcome to 4.1.
4.1 Flex, where it gets real.
And fake.
Yeah. Where we get real about fake facial hair.
What are you talking about? This mustache is all natural.
It's all natural, man. USDA organic.
Approved by the Farmers Association of America.
This farmer's mustache was farmed by farmers in America.
You don't have to be lonely.
I hope that's not your life. Your end goal here. After today, I can start my farmers only profile. Been waiting for you. ears. They're gonna be like, why is Yosemite Sam on here?
Because farmers only.
So what I'm doing now is I'm just kind of trimming off some stray hairs so I can pull them out. Maybe. Now, something I've learned from experience here is, and from watching other people and make professionals do some videos, is once you get it all in place, it's nice to take your towel or a little hand cloth, washcloth, and really press that mustache down, or whatever facial hair you've done, into that spirit gum. This helps give you one last little connection, and you can kind of see the true length of it and trim away some more. Oops, sorry.
That's good.
Okay. Come back in. Make it a little fluffier. Okay. It's not exactly perfect, but most facial hair won't be exactly perfect because humans are imperfect. Except for me.
Well, naturally.
All right.
Of course.
Of course.
Oh my god, you can be a cop now.
Someone get him some donuts and coffee. There's an emergency downtown. I need donuts and coffee still. Alright. So, now, I'm going to clean my brush with a little rubbing alcohol. Do you want to keep this on?
Yeah.
Okay.
For the rest of his life.
Of course.
Awesome. Okay. Well, you can keep it on. The only thing I'm going to tell you guys is, like, if you did want to take it off, you just soak your brush in rubbing alcohol. And actually go through, use it like a little mop or a broom and just push the facial hair off the face. And it will dissolve that spirit gum. And it'll come off. You can save it even by going gradually from one side to the other and peel it off. Because once that spirit gum solidifies, it will like almost like crystallize on your face. And then you can gradually peel it all off. It'll still fall apart if you pull on it, but like, it'll hold together tenuously.
In case you want
to, save
it,
you keep it like pressed between the pages of your favorite book. You know, yeah, maybe you're reading the Danielle Steel novel at home.
You can wear it every Wednesday night.
Yeah. Every time you go to the VFW now, which I assume was that was really your end goal.
Yeah.
It's not Farmers Only. Yeah.
Although Farmers Only is a good alternative.
Yeah.
Sure.
Make sure you get it completely off. Like, because when I actually took his class and I did sideburns, I had the great idea. I don't have time to use spirit gum remover or rubbing alcohol, so I just took it off. It takes skin off, like a top layer of skin, so like for a month, I had like not very much skin there, so please. Make sure you get it completely off and completely soak it with like rubbing alcohol or spirit gum remover or something, because it really hurts. I'm not joking, it hurts.
More life lessons.
Yeah.
And once again, you know, we always use Bentonite products in this school, just because I'm most familiar with them. So a little shout out to Bentonite. You want to sponsor us?
Or Bill Nye, if you want to sponsor us.
Bill Nye, too, the science guy.
All the Nyes.
But I would like to reiterate that this is 4.1 Flex YouTube makeup tutorials. We've had a lot of fun today. Hopefully we learn. Get a glimpse at this nice finished mustache.
Wow.
Subscribe to my YouTube channel.
Hit that like button.
Marks, link in bio.
Oh, bye-bye.